At the International Myeloma Workshop, I had the opportunity to do a presentation that was entitled Metabolomics. And fortunately, my presentation was not a standalone. We saw a growing number of groups that are working on this particular topic. At the end of the day, when we talk about metabolomics, we talk about all the consequences that occur downstream of DNA, RNA, the protein, and essentially it goes into how the cells actually do their day-to-day operation. My presentation was largely focused on how our understanding of the normal biology of plasma cells has led to a better understanding of the mechanism of actions of certain drugs. In particular, one of the things that we have learned is that as plasma cells become highly, highly specialized in the production of antibodies, they become professional antibody factories, they compromise in that that specificity and that efficiency in production of proteins also creates certain vulnerabilities. Now, we have seen this historically with agents such as the proteasome inhibitors. So proteasome inhibitors initially thought to disrupt the protein metabolism and create chaos through that. More recently, we think there may be a second side of this, which might be disruption of the supply chain, if you may, of amino acids for cells that becomes highly toxic. But also in particular, our group has been very interested in the effects of the group of drugs we call the immunomodulatory drugs, so the lenalidomides and the pomalidomides of the world, and have found that in addition to what we know they do through some of the inhibition of transcription signaling and, lower levels of IRF4 and MYC, they also participate in disruption of this protein metabolism. The publication of one of the scientists in our group has shown that the immunomodulatory drugs can interfere with the process of detoxifying plasma cells as they are folding proteins. And this is very interesting. As monoclonal proteins are being produced by the cell, they're always, produced by one cell produces a monoclonal protein, even if it's not a neoplastic process. These cells go through the process of disulfide bond formation. And every time a bond is formed, there's a molecule of hydrogen peroxide that is released. And it's so frequent that every plasma cell produces somewhere between 100,000 and a million molecules per second of peroxide. So the plasma cells, to be great factories, have had to adapt and have machinery that very quickly can dispose of this peroxide. And it does so by cleaving it into the components of water and oxygen. And we have found this is one mechanism. There's other mechanisms that involve amino acids metabolism, lactate transport. The group from Dr. Basserman from Germany has identified a critical component of this whole pathway and how, lactic acid is actually managed. And we believe at the end, the full understanding of all of this will allow for better, more precise, perhaps deeper forms of treatment for multiple myeloma.